guys, welcome back. We are going to paint the inner wheel wells, the core support, and the fan shroud for this 59 Impala. Believe it or not, I am still waiting on parts. I'm still waiting on some parts for the power steering and a few other little parts before I can start putting the rest of this car together. I had to pull the steering column. The steering column was broke inside. It's sitting over here on the table. There was a part inside this tube. You can't, probably not gonna be able to see it, but it's a cast part. And what it does is when you have the lever in there and you move back and forth, that's not the right hole. But anyways, it's right over here. If you put the lever in here, when you go to pull the lever forward, it's supposed to release this down so that it can travel farther over. Well, that casting is broken there, so we are working on getting another steering column so that we can get that painted, put back in the car. So this type of stuff I cannot do with the inner wheel wells and the fenders and everything on, because there's no way I would be able to reach into there and take care of that stuff. So I've already sanded down the inner wheel wells, the core support, and the fan shroud. They're in here warming up. So they're all sanded down, ready to go. This is some gray epoxy primer showing through. We're not gonna do the underside. The underside, once the car is assembled, I'm just gonna hit it with some satin black spray can. So what I wanna do is mix up some single stage. We're gonna go with gloss black rather than satin black, just for these parts here. So I'm gonna get these things wiped off and then we can start mixing up some paint. All right, I'm gonna blow all these parts off again and then wax the grease removal. Single stage gloss black. It's a 4-to-1 mix, and we'll probably put a little bit of reducer in there just to thin it out a little bit. I got a little bit left in this can, and I have a full can on the mixer right now. So we're gonna go up to the number 4, up to 4, and then 10% reducer. All There's only a little bit in here. It's been on there for about 10 minutes. I put it in the shaker upside down so that all the heavy paint at the bottom of the can goes and gets mixed up. And you can wet sand and buff this stuff. So if the top of the wheel wells, you know, get a little dirt and they don't look perfect, I could just lightly hit it with some 1500 grit and hit them with the buffer and it'll look beautiful. Poke my holes in the rim so that the paint can flow back into the can. After I'm done pouring it, I hate pouring out of a brand new gallon, it usually makes a mess. Pretty much always makes a mess. So we're gonna, I know I got cardboard down, but let's put some paper towels here too. So I gotta get this up to the number 4. We're halfway there. Nope, I went a little high, but that's okay. I'll just adjust. I went just a little bit above 4, so we'll just go the same thing over here. Right there. And then we gotta put our 10% reducer in. Which now we're gonna take it up to the 20% line. That'll be good enough. I'm gonna get this mixed up, get it in the gun, and we will go out there. We're gonna blow the parts off one more time with the blow gun. I don't think I'm really gonna mess with the tack rag. I think we're just gonna blow gun them off real good, and then we're gonna go ahead and apply a couple coats. Now make sure that you don't put this stick into your gallon of paint. This one's empty, because there's hardener on this now. So you don't wanna sticking it in your gallon and you'll end up getting hard chunks in your paint. So, all right, I'm gonna get this mixed up. We're gonna go out there, blow them off, and put a couple coats of black on. Okay, that's all I'm doing, two coats. It laid down really nice. There's no point in pushing it. No point in wasting material for a third coat. I'm gonna get my gun cleaned out, and then we can go out there after it flows down for a few minutes, and we will take a look at it. So I'm gonna go ahead and get my gun and the garbage cleaned up, and then I will be back. All right, let's go take a look at them. I'm not even gonna wet sand and buff any of this stuff. It's plenty good enough. Most of this stuff gets covered anyways. You only really see the top of the rear support, the top of these wheel wells. All this is all hidden. Little bit of orange peel, but barely any really. Not bad at all. Now, I don't make this stuff. This Summit single stage does not work with heat. It starts to die back really bad, and it'll solvent pop if you're not careful with heat. So I'm only spraying at 70 degrees. I don't want to go any hotter than that. That's what it's been at here for about 20-30 minutes. So I'm going to run the 70 degrees with the fans going for about another 10 minutes. And then I'm just going to turn everything off, shut the lights off, let it sit here until tomorrow, and then it'll be cured. So, alright guys, this is going to end this video. We'll be painting some other parts, the hood hinges and stuff like that, later on this week. Other than that, thanks for watching. If you like what you're seeing, please like and subscribe. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to ask. Oh, one other thing, when I paint inside of here, I'll Scotch-Brite them all up when they're already bolted on the car just to clean things up. But there she is sitting out there. Can't wait to get this thing finished up and out of my hair. So, all right, guys, once again, thanks for watching. Please like, subscribe. I will see you guys later.